Hi, in this session we are going to learn a HackerRank problem titled Game of Thrones. First let's read the question and try to understand what we need to perform in this particular problem. Dothraki are planning an attack to usurp King Robert's throne. King Robert learns of this conspiracy from Ravan and plans to lock the single door through which the enemy can enter his kingdom. But to lock the door, he needs a key that is an anagram of a palindrome. He starts to go through his box of strings, checking to see if they can be rearranged into a palindrome. For example, given a string like the AABBCCDD, one way it can be arranged into a palindrome is ABCDDCBA, which is a palindrome. Right? The task in this particular program is, you will be given a string, you need to verify, can it be rearranged into a palindrome. If you can rearrange into a palindrome, then you print S on the screen. Otherwise, you print no on the screen. What a simple one, right? There'll be only one input string, which only consists of alphabets A to Z and in lowercase, right? Okay. Okay, they are given some examples out here, like AAA followed by 4Bs. You can make a palindrome out of this. Remember, there can be various ways in which you can make this. Like you can have 2Bs at the beginning, 2Bs at the end, and 3As in the middle. That is one way to do it. Or you can have 1A at the beginning, 1A at the end, and followed by 2Bs in the second and third character, then followed by A in between, and then followed by BBA. Right? So there are various ways in which you can basically make this as a palindrome. Fine. If you can make a palindrome of a given string, you print S on the screen. If you cannot make it, then you print no, right? Let us try to see how we can think of solving this particular problem, right? And then we'll try to get into the implementation. One way to solve this particular problem is, given a string, you generate all the permutations. And after generating all the permutations, you basically verify, do we have any palindromes among the various permutations what is generated? Like for example, if I consider a string like ABC, the various permutations of ABC will be like ABC, ACB, CAB, BAC, BCA, and CBA. Now look out for any palindrome string in this. Did you find any palindrome here? No. So it means ABC can never be arranged in a way which can form a palindrome. Now let us take up AAB. Now try to create all the permutations for this. AAB, ABA, BAA, AAB, and ABA, and BAA. And from this, what you observed is, yes, there is a palindrome. You can just observe ABA is a palindrome, meaning AAB can be arranged into a palindrome. So for this case, you should print yes. For the previous case, ABC should print no. For this case, you need to print A. Now, this particular method, logically, it seems perfectly fine, but to implement this, it's going to be very time consuming. When I say time consuming, it basically takes a lot of time to generate all the permutations, right? Now, to understand how many permutations we need to generate, let's take a simple example. If you have a string of length 1, you can only have one permutation. If you have a string of length 2, like consider AB, you can have two permutations. Like we can have AB followed by BA. Whereas if the length of the string is 3, you can have 6 permutations, like what you have seen in the previous two examples. If the length of the string is 4, then we can have 24 permutations. And if the length of the string is 5, we can have 120 permutations. From this, what we learned is the number of permutations what you can generate is n factorial, wherein n is the length of the string. And we have seen in the sample inputs given in HackerRank that the length of the strings were quite large. So you can just imagine the number of permutations what you need to create, right? For 6, it will be like 720. For 7, it will be like somewhere around 5,000 something, right? Okay, so it'll be huge, okay? Now, there is another method through which we can solve this particular problem. Whenever you take up any palindrome string, you know that the first character and last character will be same. Second and second last will be same. Third and third last will be same. Fourth and fourth last will be same. Okay, in order to perform this, you know that the characters occur in pairs, because the first and last, second and second last, third and third last, right? Now, if you have a string which is of even length, now every character will be in pairs, in the sense they'll have even frequency. In case if the length of the string is odd, you can have one character which can have an odd occurrence, which will go generally in the between, and every other character should have even frequency. Perfect? Okay. We'll be using this particular method to solve the problem. The first thing is you need to read the data. So before we could read the data, I just want to print some message out here. Okay, enter the input. Remember, this input, we will not be putting it into the HackerRank one. Write this message. I'll just try to write this to read the data. Now you need to calculate the frequency. Now there are various ways in which you can calculate the frequency. One way is you can basically have an array of 26 characters, because the input says that you'll have only lowercase a to z. And then every time you encounter a character, you go to that corresponding index, you add one to it. That's one way to do it. Or otherwise, what you can do it is you can basically use the concept of a dictionary, wherein you can match up the key value pair, like every character you encounter, you check out that if it's already occurred, just increase the frequency count of that. Otherwise, okay, you add a frequency, okay, you add an entry to dictionary with the value one, right? Okay. Now, if you want to do this task, you have to create a dictionary, and then you need to scan every character, you need to check out if it is existing, and okay, and all those information. Now there is another way through which you can do the same kind of task, creating a dictionary of frequencies. Now, using a built-in class called as counter, and that class is present in a library called as collections. We'll try to import that particular library. Fine. After that, we'll just try to utilize the counter class from collections, right? We'll pass on the data, and this will give me the frequency. I'll try to print the frequency out here, and you can understand, okay, what does it gives. And then once we understand this, then we'll try to proceed further to the next task. Python 3 followed by file name, right? I'll try to say madam, right? M has two occurrences, A has two occurrences, D has one occurrence, right? Okay, or I'd like to just run this, and then I'll try to say hello, right? L has two occurrences, all the other three has one occurrence. So we learned this particular problem. Okay, now once we generate the frequency, remember this one line is sufficient for us to generate the frequency, right? Okay, if you don't want to utilize that, you can use the method what I've used in SOC Merchant, right? You can follow the same. Now, once you generate the frequency, you need to scan through the frequency, right? Remember, the frequency will be a kind of dictionary which has the key, which is the alphabets, and then the value part is the frequency value. Okay, so I just write for key in frequency. I would like to get the value part. Value part is frequency of key. And once I get this value part, I'd like to check out that is the odd number or even number, right? To verify this, I'll just try to check. If this is even number, proceed further. If it is odd number, I want to keep track of how many odd numbers are there, right? I'd like to write count equal to zero. The first time you encounter odd number, we basically say that, okay, fine, count has to be incremented by one, right? Okay. Now, once you come out of this loop, the count value should be zero, or it can be one. It'll be zero in case, if every character has even frequency, and it will be one if only one of the character has odd frequency, every other character has equal frequency. But in case the count value has a value which is more than one, then it means that you cannot make a palindrome, right? So I'd like to verify if count value is zero or count value is one, then I'd like to say that you can make this as a palindrome, otherwise you cannot make it as a palindrome, right? Okay, now let me just try to run this particular code. I'd like to write right. Okay, now you can just take out this. This is an anagram of madam. Madam is a palindrome. You can just observe this. I can make a palindrome out here because there is only one character which has an odd frequency. Every other character has even frequency. Now let me try to take up something like this. Daddy, right? In fact, here we have three characters whose frequency is odd, so we cannot make it. Or if you want to take this Malayalam, right? Okay, ye has a frequency of 4, but remember it is even. 4 is also even, right? There is only one character which has odd frequency. And remember, it's not necessary that you have to give up, okay, a palindrome. It can be a non-palindrome also, but okay, it has to have the frequency so that if you want, you can rearrange them into a palindrome. Like for example, let us say, I'll say M, L, A, A, Y, A, L, A, M. Right, this is not a palindrome, but I can make a palindrome from this. Right, I can make a palindrome. Fine, guys, that's it. Now, you don't need to print this particular task or this particular line and this line. Everything else is same. So, I'd like to take this particular code, go to HackerRank, and then select the language as Python. Don't worry with whatever the code you see here, don't worry at all about that. Right. You just try to paste this code, that's it, and then right, it passed the sample test cases. We'll submit this. Right guys, passed all the test cases and here is the code. Right, remember this program gave us an opportunity to learn about a counter class which is present in collections library, right? Without using this, you can actually write 2-3 lines of code wherein you can either use a dictionary or you can use an array and update the frequency, any one of the methods. Fine, clear. Thank you.